Try to break me, try to take me out, but I got Jesus on my side. So bad I thought it would die, but ain't no power stronger than the one that came and laid down his life. And I got mountains to climb. Hey boys and girls, welcome to another Saturday and another virtual youth church service here at Allen Temple. I'm your youth pastor, the Reverend Kevin Aldridge, and as always, I'm so excited and happy to be here with you all and learning about the Lord and how we can be better Christians, right? And so before we get into the message this week, I wanted to just talk to each and every one of you to make sure that you're still doing all of the safety precautions that you need to be doing to make sure that you're keeping yourself safe during this period of COVID-19. We need to be making sure that we've got our trusty face masks on and that we're washing our hands as frequently as we possibly can, and that we're doing social distancing, staying 6 feet away from people whenever we can. So just make sure you're taking care of yourself and make sure the people around you are doing what they're supposed to be doing too, because it's real easy right now. It seems like some things are getting back to normal and you see people out and they're shopping, and I even seen a group of people on the basketball court outdoors the other day playing. And so it might seem like stuff is getting back to normal, but we got to remember the virus is still out there. We want to make sure everybody is being safe and taking care of themselves. So make sure that you're masking up and doing all that stuff. I know it's a pain. I know it's a hassle. It's stuff that we probably don't want to do and we get sick and tired of doing it. But it's better to be sick and tired of doing the things that we need to do than being sick, right? So remember that. Take care of yourself right now, and I'll keep you in prayer that God will keep us all safe and healthy. So we got a great lineup for us coming up this week, starting with our Sunday school lesson. And our Sunday school lesson is going to focus today on being a doer and not just a hearer. So I'm excited to hear this Sunday school lesson. So I hope you will buckle in, pay attention, and listen what the Lord wants you to learn today. Try to break me, try to take me out, but I got Jesus
on my side. So bad I thought it would die. Hello. Lesson 10 comes from the book of James. James stresses the importance of being not just hearers of God's word, but doers also. Our story: be a doer, not just a hearer. Tracy loved cupcakes. Her favorite flavors were chocolate and strawberry lemonade. For her birthday, her grandmother gave her a cookbook filled with cupcake recipes. First, Tracy studied the colorful photographs. Next, she read each recipe aloud, taking notes, highlighting important directions, and bookmarking pages that had the yummiest looking cupcakes. She read and reread the cookbook so many times, some of the pages became loose and the cover began to fall off. One day, her grandmother came over for dinner. Tracy's mother had made a grand feast, but when it was over, Grandma still sat at the table. "Grandma, are you going to join us in the family room? We're about to watch a movie." Tracy was puzzled at her grandmother sitting at the empty table. "Oh, I was just waiting for dessert," her grandmother replied. "I thought you would have baked some cupcakes, and I couldn't wait to try one." "Grandma, I just read the cookbook. I never actually tried a recipe." "Why not? All the steps are written down and you have all the ingredients in your pantry." "It's too hard, Grandma," Tracy tried to think of all the reasons why she avoided baking. "Plus, it'll probably take too long or be too messy for me to do." "Tracy," her grandmother asked gently, "what good is reading a cupcake cookbook if you are not going to use it to bake?" Tracy thought about her grandmother's words, and a couple of hours later, she presented to her grandmother a platter full of homemade strawberry lemonade cupcakes dripping with chocolate icing. "Wow," Tracy marveled at the delicious dessert. "There's a big difference between reading a cookbook and using it. I'm loving the result. Have you ever been given a book filled with things to do and never used it? Why or why not?" Our memory verse, James chapter 1, verse 22. "Do not merely listen to the word and so deceive yourselves. Do what it says." If those who think they are religious don't control the words they use, James tells us that they are deceiving themselves. and their religion is worthless. He goes on to say that true religion is caring for people who need help and also staying away from sin. When you consider that this definition of religion first starts with what happens with your tongue, we can conclude that how we talk to and about others, especially those who need help, is a sign of how truly close we are to God. James says in verses 23 through 24 that being a hearer and not a doer of the word is like looking in a mirror, seeing something wrong, and not fixing it. So ask God now for forgiveness and think of ways that your words and actions can be used to bring help and healing. So in conclusion, read your Bible and do what it says. Do your schoolwork and put it to good use, and wear your mask and stay safe. Thank you.
Hey, boys and girls, wasn't that an awesome Sunday school lesson? I hope you listened well and paid attention so that you can be a doer and not just a hearer. Now it's going to be time for our YPD Minute, and Miss Trina is going to take it away here in just a second. But before she gets into her conversation about YPD, virtual YPD week, we got a couple of great presentations that you all have put together. First, we've got Zoe, who's going to be coming forward, and she's going to be reading a great and inspirational poem that she wrote about Black Lives Matter. And then after that, we're going to have a special presentation where we're going to get to learn a little bit about our pastor, the Reverend Alphonse Allen. So I'm looking forward to those presentations and learning about virtual YPD week. So listen up, Miss Trina, go ahead and take it away.
Try to break me, try to take me out, but I got Jesus on my side. So bad I thought it would die.
Hi, my name is Zoe Hutton, and I'm trying to tell how Black Lives Matter. You and I can't breathe. The town's protesting. What is Black Lives Matter? Families and friends live together. But the world changed Earth because the incidents. We all love and heal our friends and families. Because Black Lives Matter. We're all counting on George Floyd. We all love and protect for him. We can still pray for him because Black Lives Matter. Sharing and caring together, we can all be friends and families forever. Don't kill and murder because Black Lives Matter. Prayer and love is for George. Pray for him, Jesus, and the Lord. Because no matter what race you are, because my heart will go on for my soul because Black Lives Matter.
Reverend Dr. Alphonse Allen Jr. is the senior pastor of Allen Temple African Methodist Episcopal Church in Cincinnati. Ohio is one of the oldest Black churches this side of the Mississippi. Dr. Allen is a member of the General Board and the church. Dr. Allen serves as the dean of the Ohio South Ohio Board of Examiners, which helps young seminarians become better equipped to preach the word and pastor God's people. He serves on the Department of Church Growth and Development for the AME Church.
Under Reverend Allen's guidance, the church has developed and operates a community food pantry which serves the surrounding communities where the church is located. The temple also works closely with the XL Club, a coming-of-age organization that awards scholarships to young ladies who will be attending college. Allen Temple continues to have a growing relationship with the Cincinnati Opera, the Cincinnati Symphony, as well as the 100 African American Men's Choir of Cincinnati, which sponsors Cincinnati youth to attend Black college campus tours.
Prior to coming to the temple, Dr. Allen served as senior pastor of the United African Methodist Episcopal Church in Zena, Ohio, for 5 years. At United, Dr. Allen was affiliated with the Zena Area Association of Churches and the Greene County African American Ministerial Alliance, where he served as president. Dr. Allen also served as an adjunct professor at Wilberforce University, where he enjoyed teaching our brilliant young minds. Dr. Allen's presence was noticeably visible at the university as well as in the community at large.
Dr. Allen serves on the board of directors for the Richard Allen Schools of Dayton. He is actively involved in the Cincinnati community and with the Community Action Agency. Dr. Allen is instrumental in the development of Undivided, a partnership with various churches in Cincinnati working to unify and develop cultural diversity among the organizations. He is also a life member of the NAACP.
Dr. Allen was born and raised in Sharon, Pennsylvania, where he was an active member of Greater Morris Chapel African Methodist Episcopal Church, Farrell, Pennsylvania, a graduate of the University of Pittsburgh. He received a Bachelor of Science degree in Physiology, as well as a Bachelor of Arts degree in African Studies. Dr. Allen also earned a Master's of Divinity degree from the prestigious Payne Theological Seminary, Wilberforce, Ohio, where he graduated first in his class. In May 2006, Dr. Allen completed the Doctor of Ministry degree from United Theological Seminary, Dayton, Ohio. The degree Dr. Allen is most proud of, his degree in Common Sense, which he obtained at Kane Allen University, the home of his praying mother. Dr. Allen has been a born-again Christian since July 1984 and accepted his calling to preach a year later under Reverend Dr. James H. Harris, his father in ministry. He has pastored several churches over the past 30 years. He is married to our First Lady, Fran Allen, since September 20, 1984. He is the proud father of two children, Hasim and Alexis. Out of all things mentioned, Dr. Allen wants you to know first and foremost that he is the child of the living God.
Hey guys, just stopping in to see if you all have been saving the date like we talked about for the past couple of weeks, because our YPD virtual district event has starting this week. So on Sunday, August the 9th at 7:30 p.m., we're going to start off with a prayer service, and then it'll continue on through Thursday, August the 13th. We'll have various different events that'll be held on the district's YouTube channel. So you can check Allen Temple's social media sites as well as the Third District social media sites for further details. And you can also see it on these flyers that you see up for you. And we hope that you log on and participate. Thank you.
Try to break me, try to take me out, but I got Jesus on my side. So bad I thought it would die.
Hey, our scripture lesson this week is going to come out of the Old Testament book of Exodus, the third chapter. And we're going to read starting at verse 7. And there it says, "Then the Lord said, I have observed the misery of my people who are in Egypt. I have heard their cry on account of their taskmasters. Indeed, I know their sufferings, and I have come down to deliver them from the Egyptians and to bring them up out of that land to a good and broad land, a land flowing with milk and honey, to the country of the Canaanites, the Hittites, and the Amorites, the Perizzites, the Hivites, and the Jebusites. The cry of the Israelites has now come to me. I have also seen how the Egyptians oppressed them. So come, I will send you to Pharaoh to bring my people, the Israelites, out of Egypt." But Moses said to God, "Who am I that I should go to Pharaoh and bring the Israelites out of Egypt?" Now I'm going to skip ahead, boys and girls, and we're going to go to chapter 4, and I want to read just a couple verses out of chapter 4 that will help you, starting at verse 1. And it says, "Then Moses answered, but suppose they do not believe me or listen to me, but say, the Lord did not appear to you. The Lord said to him, what is that in your hand? He said, a staff. And he said, throw it on the ground. So he threw the staff on the ground, and it became a snake. And Moses drew back from it. Then the Lord said to Moses, reach out your hand and seize it by the tail. So he reached out his hand and grasped it, and it became a staff in his hand. So they may believe that the Lord, the God of their ancestors, the God of Abraham, Isaac, and Jacob, has appeared to you." May the Lord add a blessing to the readers, hearers, and those who live by his holy word. I just want to talk to you for a couple minutes today, boys and girls, from the subject topic of God does extraordinary things with ordinary people. All right? God does extraordinary things with ordinary people. So we're familiar with that story out of the Bible that I read for you in the scripture today. It's when Moses first encountered God at the burning bush. And we know that God was calling Moses because he had a job for him to do. He wanted Moses to go to Pharaoh and to free the Israelites who had been kept in slavery under Pharaoh's rule for hundreds of years. And God was going to send Moses to do this big job, right? Kind of hard to believe that one man could walk up to Pharaoh, who at that time was probably as powerful as our president is, one of the most powerful people on the planet. He was sending little old Moses to go confront Pharaoh and free all of his people. Well, if that sounds like too big to believe for you, just imagine how Moses felt. In fact, Moses even said to God, he said, "Who am I that I should go and free the people from Egypt? Why are they going to listen to me? Why are you picking me? I'm nobody special." But God wanted Moses to understand that he can take ordinary people like him and do extraordinary things. To prove it to Moses, when Moses challenged him, like, "Why would people believe me if even if I said you sent them? What sign do I have to show them that I'm telling the truth?" And so God took the staff that Moses had, another ordinary object, an ordinary stick, something Moses probably didn't think much of, and he turned it into a snake right in front of Moses' eyes. And Moses was shocked, and he even drew back from it. But God, in an effort to not get Moses to be afraid, told him to go ahead and grab it by the tail, and the snake turned back into a stick. So Moses went ahead, did what God told him. He went to Egypt, confronted Pharaoh. He used that ordinary stick that God had given him to send down plagues from heaven onto Egypt, and eventually the people were freed. And there was even one point where they had gotten away and they came to the Red Sea, if we can remember, and it looked like it was over for the Israelites and Moses, because Pharaoh was coming back after them and they were caught between Pharaoh's army and the Red Sea with nowhere to go. But that ordinary stick that God had sent Moses with, he used it to part the Red Sea, and the people crossed over onto dry land and began on the journey to the promised land that God had promised them. So boys and girls, what I want us to understand from this Bible story today is that God can take ordinary things, ordinary people. He can take a stick and he can use it to work wonders. He can take an ordinary person like Moses and use him to free a nation of people from one of the most powerful and oppressive people on the planet. All things are possible through God. And you don't have to be anything special. In fact, God often used people who weren't that particularly special to do great things in the Bible. The Bible is filled with stories of ordinary people doing great things. So what I want you to understand today is you may be sitting back at home and saying to yourself, "Well, I'm not that special. I'm not that talented. There's nothing super about me. How is God going to be able to use me to do anything great?" Well, what we have to understand is that as long as we have faith in God, and as long as we follow God's teachings and we're loyal to God, God can work miracles through us. He can do great things through us. And truth be told, we're not ordinary to begin with, because we're made in God's image and His Spirit is inside of each and every one of us. So if we're made in God's image and His Spirit is already inside of us, we're far from ordinary. We're capable of great things already. We just have to learn to trust in God and believe in God and the value that He's placed in each and every one of us. So don't underestimate yourself, and also don't underestimate the things that God puts around you and that He provides you with. You may not have the greatest car, the most fancy car to drive around if you're of driving age, but be thankful for what you have, because God can use that for great things. You may not live in the greatest or fanciest house in the neighborhood, but you can still, God can still use an ordinary house for glorious things. My house isn't that luxurious or great, but I use my house for all kinds of ministry purposes. I have people into my house for worship and different things like that to glorify God. Use whatever God has blessed you with to glorify Him, because God can do great things with it. So there you have it, boys and girls. Understand that God can do extraordinary things with ordinary people and ordinary things. We just have to trust and believe in Him. See, the power wasn't in the stick. Understand that. The stick was just a stick. But the power came from God, in which He infused it with. So God can infuse us with that same power and use it for His glory and His uplifting. All right? So hopefully that'll help you feel a little bit better about yourself and maybe some of the things around you. So that's all I've got for you this week. Until next Saturday, remember, you are extraordinary, extraordinary in the eyes of God. We'll turn it over now for our YPD benediction. Until next week, be safe and healthy.
Try to break me, try to take me out, but I got Jesus on my side. So bad I thought it would die.
In the name of the triune God, may the spirit of Christian missions enter every heart. This we ask in Jesus' name. Amen.
Ain't nobody stopping my shine. They try to break me, try to take me out, but I got Jesus on my side. So bad I thought it would die. But ain't no power stronger than the one that came and laid down his life. And I got mountains to climb, but the enemy can't stop me, cause there's a calling on my life. So when I'm crying, don't last too long, cause he gon' step in and make it alright. Only do it, you said you would. Fight your battles for you, they gon'